Hi, everyone. WLKY meteorologist Jared Heil. Thanks for stopping by at WLKY.com for a Hurricane Sandy tropical weather forecast. Over the next several days, a lot of impacts from this storm as it heads north and northeast and eventually back toward the west. It's going to go all kinds of different directions, but the big problem is it's heading right for the big cities of the northeastern U.S. Wind speeds right now 80 miles an hour, slowly moving north and exiting the Bahamas, and you notice all of the intense storm activity is on the north side of the center of circulation, which is just now leaving the northern tip of the Bahamas. That means this storm is encountering what we call wind shear, and that does not allow the storm to breathe in the upper levels of the cyclone. So this is not a good situation for this storm's livelihood, but it is expected to actually begin to intensify once again as it gains latitude and heads away from the state of Florida over the next couple of days. So here's a forecast model. Takes it offshore of the Carolinas between Bermuda and North Carolina and Cape Hatteras over the weekend. And then by Monday night, Tuesday, it's going to recurve back toward the west, courtesy of a big blocking high pressure center over Greenland. That's not going to allow this thing to go back out to sea like they normally do. It's going to take it right back toward the big city. So anywhere from Massachusetts, Connecticut, Jersey, New York State, Pennsylvania, all the way down toward the Delmarva is going to see a pretty big storm from this thing. If it heads farther north and impacts areas like Cape Cod with a direct hit, that would keep the water going offshore of New York City, which means the Hudson River and Long Island Sound areas like that would not see the water piling up into the big city. But if it passes toward the south, which is what the majority of the models would like to do with this storm system at this time, that's going to push all that water, courtesy of a northeast breeze, southeast breeze, I should say, right into New York City. So a lot of problems from that, and that could create a lot of flooding. Here are some of the impacts that this storm is going to have across a huge chunk of real estate: battering waves and storm surge at the coast, wind and flooding, and millions of people may lose power, and then finally some snow as you look inland toward the mountainous areas of the northern Appalachians. So a lot of impacts from that storm around here. As we look forward to our forecast, temperatures are chilly with scattered showers, but no impacts from Sandy other than the chilly temperatures the next several days. I'm Jared Heil. Have a great weekend.